Hello students, welcome back to maths class. So we will finish our Lagrange's mean value theorem with these two problems today. So come on, come to the first problem. Verify Rolle's theorem for f of x is equal to this one. So already I explained what is the procedure to verify the Rolle's theorem. So first we have to show that whether it is continuous, whether it is differentiable, then f of a must be equals to f of b. Then we have to find one c value by taking f dash c is equal to 0, and that c value must lies within that minus 3 and 8. Then we can say that Rolle's theorem is verified. Right, so come on. So first question, what is the given function to you? So given function is, what is given function? F of x is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Okay, so find out f dash x. Why? We need f dash c is equal to 0, there we want f dash x, no, for that. So it is d by dx of f of x. So is equal to d by dx of f of x, x square minus 5x plus 6. Okay, so is equal to d by dx of x square minus 5 into d by dx of x plus d by dx of 6. Okay, so is equal to, it is d by dx of x square, you know it very well, it is what is that, 2x, right? So minus 5 into d by dx of x is 1, 1 into 5 is 5, and d by dx of 6 is 0. So this is your f dash x value, right? 2x minus 5. Okay, now come to the first condition. What is that? Again, it is a polynomial equation, right? So since f is polynomial equation, polynomial equation, right? So number one, what is that? F is continuous. You write full form, continuous on minus 3, 8. Okay, similarly f is differentiable, right? Differentiable on open interval minus 3, 8. All polynomial equations are continuous on all domains. Similarly, all polynomial equations are differentiable, right, on all domains. Okay, so now come to the third condition. Third condition, we have to find f of a must be equals to f of b. So f of a means a is minus 3, b is 8. So f of minus 3 in the given function, right, we have to substitute minus 3. Okay, so come on, minus 3 whole square, 5 into minus 3 plus 6, okay, is equal to how much? 3 is a 9, minus into minus plus, right, plus 5, again minus into minus plus, 5 3 is a 15, right, plus 6. Okay, so 9 plus 6, 15, 15 plus 15, 30. Okay, so now you find out f of b. So f of b is equal to f of next value is 8, right? So b value is 8. We have to substitute in the given function, right? So it is 8 square minus 5 into 8 plus 6. Okay, so 8 8s are 64. And 8 5 is how much? 40 plus 6. 70 minus 40 is equal to 30. So what is that? F of A is equal to F of B, right? So all the three conditions satisfied. Now we have to find which value we have to find? C, right? Such that, how we have to find? By using the formula F dash C is equal to 0. So come on, what is your F dash X? F dash X is 2x minus 5. So F dash C is equal to 0 means in X place we have to take C. So 2C minus 5 is equal to 0. So 2C is equal to 5. Then C is equal to 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. Definitely 2.5 lies in between minus 3 to 8. Isn't it? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Before 8. So definitely this 2.5 lies in between minus 3 and 8. I am not saying exactly it should be middle value. It lies in between minus 3 and 8. It may be a number in between minus 3 and 8. So we can write. So Rolle's theorem is verified. So therefore we have to get such a C value which lies in between the given interval. Okay, so we got C is equal to 2.5 which lies in between minus 3 and 8. So therefore, come on, Rolle's theorem is verified, right? Theorem is verified. Okay, so that is the answer. Next, come to the second question. Verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the function f of x is equal to log x on 1, 2. So come on, first we have to write what is the given function to you. Given function is, right? Given function is, what is that? F of x is equal to log x, right? On which interval? Closed interval 1, 2. Okay, so we are doing Lagrange's, no? Find out f dash x. So how we will find? D by dx of f of x. So is equal to d by dx of log x is equal to, d by dx of log x is 1 by x, right? We did in differentiation. So next you find out your f of b. What is f of b? F of 2, right? What is this? It should be closed both sides, right? So f of 2 is equal to, this is log 2. And find out f of a. F of a means f of 1, right? So in the function, in x place we have to take 1. So what is the given function? F of x is equal to log x. In x place 1 means here also 1. So it is log 1. So now you got your function as a logarithmic functions. All the logarithmic functions are continuous as well as differentiable, right? Since f is logarithmic function, right? So it is continuous. First condition, f is continuous on the closed interval 1, 2, and it is differentiable also. F is differentiable, right, on open interval 1, 2, right? Then we have to find which value? C. Such that, by using which formula we have to find? Lagrange's means f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. Okay, so you know your f dash x. With that we can write f dash c. Wherever x is there, there you take a c, right? So it is f dash x is equal to 1 by x, f dash c is equal to 1 by c. So 1 by c is equal to f of b. What is f of b? Log 2, right? A minus f of a. What is our f of a? Log 1, okay? By 2 minus 1 is equal to, it is log 2. Log 1 value is 0, standard form, right? 2 minus 1 is 1. So, is equal to, it is log 2. Minus 0 means log 2. Log 2 by 1 means log 2 only. So, 1 by c is equal to log 2. Actually, by Lagrange's, by Rolle's, we have to find c value, and that should be within the class interval, isn't it? So, not 1 by c, we need c. So, come on, it is 1 by log 2 is equal to c. We got 1 by c is equal to log 2. So, we want c, send c that side, bring log 2 this side. Actually, log 2 means for all logarithms, base will be a, right? It should be understood, okay? So, 1 by log 2 base e can be written as log e base 2 is equal to c. And what is the value of log e base 2 is 1.4427. So, definitely 1.4427 lies within the interval 1, 2, open interval. That means that c value must lie in between 1 and 2. Yes, we got our c value as 1.44. Definitely that value lies in between 1 and 2. So, therefore, Lagrange's theorem is verified. Okay, so Lagrange's theorem is actually Lagrange's mean value theorem, right? Theorem is verified. I think this is the last problem. Already you got the idea of how to solve Rolle's, how to solve Lagrange's. While Rolle's, we will take a c value from the formula f dash c is equal to 0. We will take f dash c is equal to 0, right? And we will solve that equation, then you will get a c. That C compulsory must lies in between the class. Then we can say that Rolle's theorem is verified. While doing the Lagrange's, right, we will find C value by applying the formula F dash C, right, is equal to F of B minus F of A by B minus A. Okay, so in Rolle's, we will go for f dash c, right? In Rolle's, the formula, we will get our c value by using f dash c is equal to 0. In Lagrange's, we will find the c value by using the formula f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a, right? But in both cases, that c value must lie in between the given class. Then only we can say that Rolle's is verified, Lagrange is verified. In both the cases, the function must be continuous function as well as differentiable function. The difference in Lagrange's and Rolle's is the third condition. In Rolle's, f of a must be equals to f of b in Rolle's. And in Lagrange's, we will find our f dash c value is f of b minus f of a by b minus a. By using that formula, we will get one equation. If you solve that equation, you will get your c value. That c value must lie within the given interval, right? So, then we can say that Lagrange's mean value theorem is verified. clear with the concept. Actually, we got polynomial equation and logarithmic equations. Maximum we will get polynomial equations. All the polynomial equations are continuous and differentiable at all the domains. So no need to check directly. You can write this is a polynomial function. So it is continuous on this interval and it is differentiable on this interval. Okay. And next in one question we got a log function. Yes, all the logarithmic functions also continuous as well as differentiable. So since the given equation, given function is logarithmic function, it is continuous, it is differentiable. Okay. So once those two conditions over, in rules we have to go for one more condition, f of a must be equals to f of b. After that f dash c we have to take, and that should be equals to 0. Then if equate that will be 0, you will get your c value. Definitely that c value will lies in between the given class interval. Then we will write at the end, Rolle's theorem is verified. In Lagrange's, after proving the two conditions, it is continuous, it is differentiable, we have to find c value by applying the formula f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. Okay. So before that you find out f dash x value, f of b value, f of a value, substitute, you will get your c value. Definitely that c will lies within the class interval. Okay, then we will write Lagrange's theorem is verified. Okay, be clear with the concepts. Okay, practice these problems perfectly. They are very simple also. It takes hardly 5 to 6 minutes, isn't it? So, make it perfect. Okay, that's all for today. Have a nice day.